Hey guys, welcome back. This is Emily. If you did not see my first episode, you can check that out. And it was basically just a summary of the types of topics I'm going to be discussing. But if you saw the last one, welcome back. And like I said last time, today we will be talking about why it took me so long to decide to pursue acting. Let me start with the fact that I have loved theater since I was a little kid. I started ballet when I was 5, and I was only able to take it for a couple years because my parents couldn't afford it. But for those couple of years, I loved it so much, and I would have continued for as long as possible. I loved going to theater. I would go to plays with my mom all the time. One of my favorite shows was My Fair Lady. Looking back, I'm like, that's a weird musical for a kid to like, but that was my favorite one growing up. And I watched the movie like all the time. So I've always loved theater. And when I was in middle school, I really wanted to audition for a youth performing arts school that's here in Louisville. But I was too scared. I wanted so badly to be part of that school, but I just could not find the courage to audition. So I ended up going to Seneca, and Seneca has a theater program. It wasn't that great of a theater program, but it was still a program. Well, freshman year, didn't audition. Sophomore year, finally I'm like, all right, I'm going to do it, I'm gonna audition. I did not audition for the musical, which musicals are the thing that I really, really love, so I still was too scared for that, but I auditioned for Much Ado About Nothing, and I got in. I didn't get any lines. I was basically an extra, but I got to dance, and I mean, it was my first role, so exciting. And that was so much fun, and I loved it. So my junior year, I auditioned for You're a Good Man, Charlie Brown, and I was in the ensemble, which that show doesn't normally have an ensemble, but in this case, it was high school, so they were like, let's add an ensemble. So anyways, I was in the ensemble. Yet again, a lot of fun. And one of my friends there actually introduced me to ballroom dancing. So I started ballroom dancing, which that will become important later. So I did You're a Good Man, Charlie Brown. And then my senior year, I was determined to get a lead. I was like, it's my senior year. And the plays were all, these were always called senior plays. And I was like the only senior in the theater department. Everyone else was like a grade below me or even younger. So I was like, I'm the only senior. I have to get the lead. We were doing Meet Me in St. Louis. And I listened to Judy Garland sing like a million times, and I tried so hard to make myself sound like her, which now I know that that's not the right approach, but at the time, high school, I was like, all right, I just gotta sound like Judy Garland and I get the lead. So I go in and I'm like, I'm gonna nail this audition. And I went in there and I thought I did awesome, and I did not get the lead. I was cast as ensemble. And it crushed me. I felt like I must suck. The reason I didn't get in was that I sucked. And I had always kind of had in the back of my mind that I wasn't very good. Partly because I have an older brother. My older brother was always like, you suck, which, I mean, older brothers do, but I guess I sort of took it to heart. And this is like the same time that American Idol was going on. I would watch American Idol and I would see these people who would audition who thought they were amazing and they sucked. And I was like, is that me? Do I suck? Is that, like, if I went on American Idol, would Simon Cowell say, you suck? Like, was my brother the only one who had ever been honest to me? Had everyone else who said, oh, you're a good singer, had they been lying this whole time and my brother was the only honest person? So I thought, man, maybe I suck. So, yeah, that was soul-crushing for me that I didn't even get a speaking part in the show. I was just ensemble. So I went to college, and I was like, I'm not pursuing acting. I am not good enough. But I couldn't give it up. So I took an acting class, and then I took another one, and I took some more, so I decided to become a musical theater minor. Because I still didn't have the confidence to go all in and major in it. So I became a musical theater minor, and since I didn't have as many classes as the majors, and since I didn't get to know the professors as well, I missed out on different classes. So really when auditions came around, I was never a top pick. I got callbacks, which was good, but I never got cast. So I leave college, and I'm like, if I couldn't even get cast in college, how am I supposed to go to somewhere like New York and get cast on Broadway? And yet again, there was still that, like, insecurity that maybe the reason I wasn't getting cast in these shows was because I sucked. Because I wasn't a good singer, because I wasn't a good dancer, because I wasn't a good actor. And so I was just really insecure. So I did not pursue acting after college. Like I had said, I mentioned before that my friend had introduced me to ballroom dancing. So I had been taking tons of ballroom classes. I mean, I was really good at ballroom dancing. This was one thing I knew I was good at ballroom dancing. So after college, I was like, I'm going to pursue ballroom dancing. I'm good at this. I could become a ballroom instructor. I'm going to do this. Screw acting, because auditioning for things sucks. So I started pursuing dancing. So I decided to pursue ballroom dancing, and I actually was really close to moving to Nashville to become a ballroom instructor at a studio down there. So I almost did that until I met the man who I was going to marry. And so we actually met salsa dancing. So I decided not to move to Nashville, and I decided not to pursue ballroom instruction anymore. And we got married, and then we had a baby. And then after my daughter was born, when she was still a little baby, my husband decided to open a restaurant. When we had a 3-month-old baby, he decided to open a restaurant. And this was right after I quit my shitty job. I used to work at a bank. I guess I won't say which bank in case I get in trouble for some reason, but I used to work at a bank and I hated it. It was awful. So after my daughter was born, I was like, this is the perfect excuse to quit my job. So I quit my job and I was a stay-at-home mom, and then my husband decides to open a restaurant. So basically my husband, he was still working at his job, thank goodness, but he was at his job, and then he would leave his job and go straight there to the restaurant, and then he wouldn't get home until like 10, 11 o'clock at night. So I was at home with a little baby the entire day, every single day of the week, and it was driving me insane, just insane. So I was like, I need to get out of the house. I cannot. I need some adult time. So I was like, well, should I go take some ballroom classes again? But by this point, like, ballroom kind of became something that I thought of as my husband and my thing. Like, this was something we did together. So I didn't really want to go dancing anymore by myself. So I was like, well, maybe I should get back into acting. So I went to a few auditions and I got cast, and I was so excited, and I thought, yes, this proves that I'm a good singer. I mean, they wouldn't cast me if I wasn't good, right? So I thought my confidence level was finally, like, going up. I thought I finally had more confidence. I mean, because after you have a baby, I mean, you can do anything, right? Like, I pushed a baby out. I can do anything. But I still had confidence problems. So the first show I was in was called Cole, and I was surrounded by super talented people. They've been doing theater for years, and they are so talented. And here I was, just, the first time I'd done any acting in several years, and I just felt like I really sucked. I had a couple of solos, and I was terrified I was going to screw it up and just let the directors down. I thought for sure I was going to go out there and just bomb, sing the wrong note, just, mess it all up. I was terrified, because when I saw these other actors and singers who knew what they were doing, and their voices were just amazing. And I felt like my voice wasn't like that. So, even though I had gotten into the show, I still was having confidence problems. Even though I had a solo in this show, even though I had duets, I was still having confidence problems. So, this did not solve my confidence issue. But eventually, I decided to start taking vocal lessons, which, duh, why didn't I do this sooner? Somehow, taking vocal lessons just, made the world of difference for me. The first couple lessons, I was still, nervous and stuff, but then I started to warm up to my instructor, and then, he said, wow, that, you sound so much better than the first time you came for lessons with me. And I was like, oh my god. He would not say I sound good unless I sound good. So I continued taking vocal lessons, continued auditioning for things, and it just started to get easier. And I realized not getting cast in something does not mean you suck. Which, duh, everyone has said that a million times. But when you don't have confidence, you don't listen. So I finally started building my confidence. So recently, I was at my job, and I'm just thinking, you know what? I have always wanted to be an actor. Why am I not doing this? Why am I not pursuing acting? Why have I let people tell me you'll never be good enough? Why have I ever let myself say that you'll never be good enough to be professional? So I finally decided, let's do it. Let's become a professional actor. So I started taking some acting classes. Like I said, I've already been taking vocal lessons. So I have an awesome vocal coach. I'm taking acting classes. And I started taking dance classes because my daughter, she started taking ballet. And I saw that there was a tap dancing class at the same exact time for adults, same exact time as my daughter's ballet class. So I was like, well, let me take tap dancing. So taking these different classes, I plan on getting new headshots, and I'm going for it. And I'm super excited, and I'm not going to let anyone get in my way, especially not myself. So that's why I'm doing it now. That's why it took me until I have a daughter to pursue acting. I think it's something about getting older. Things don't matter as much as they used to. Obviously in high school and college, when I didn't get in a show, it was the end of the world. But now, okay, I don't get in a show. That just means I get more time to spend with my daughter. Oh well. So I don't take it as personally as I used to, which I think just makes a huge difference. That is me. Thanks for watching.